I have completed my MTech and PhD in this center, and I'm working here now. So what I have been doing here might give you a glimpse about what kind of work happens here. So my work has mainly been on computer vision and augmented reality. This is one of the many domains that on which there are projects happening in WNA. So before just going into it, maybe I'll just give a small background on what these domains are. So first, computer vision. So you would be familiar with these domains. So image processing is there, where you do a lot of operations on image to enhance an image. So it could be changing the contrast of an image, or brightening an image, or adding something to an image, sharpening an image, etc. So you perform an operation on an image, and what you get is another image as the output. So in contrast to that, computer vision, so it's very related. Again, we are operating on images, but it's more like how we view an image and understand an image. So computer vision tries to do that. We see an image and try to take out meaning out of that, try to derive some knowledge out of that. So for example, we can identify different objects that are there in the image. We can do certain actions, perform certain measurements of certain parts of the image. So such category of operations is what we call computer vision, where you take an image and the output is some information or knowledge derived out of it. So I have worked around this in this area for my PhD. So this is an example. So like image processing, you can see an input image, you can get an enhanced version of the image. Computer vision, on the other hand, you can derive some information out of it. These four yellow objects are there, something like that. So in my work, actually, I focused on remote learning. So we try to apply computer vision algorithms to enhance the remote students' experience of a remote class. So this is especially very relevant during the current pandemic times, because this is the only way how classes are happening these days. And there is a big need to improve the scenario currently. So what you see on the screen now is how the learning happens, a snapshot of a typical remote learning system you can use. So even what we are doing right now. So probably a screen is shared and you could maybe see the instructor on another window. So this lot of platforms offers us. So we did a study on these platforms to see, can we improve them? What we had found was, so the e-learning systems, they are far from giving the same experience as you get in a live classroom, where you're physically there in the same room as the teacher. So one of the factors which we found was, if what we view appears very natural, as in a traditional classroom, that adds to the immersive effect you have in attending a class. So you could say, let's just stream a video of the teacher's classroom as it is. So it may not be that straightforward. So this is a snapshot of a video captured directly in the classroom. So here you can see the screen's content, they become somewhat blurred if you just capture a video. So that's where we worked on. So we try to enhance that part, which is not that straightforward. We ended up applying many computer vision algorithms to create a view which is natural-like, yet which was not a straightforward way to do it. So for example, so we want this the area of the screen alone to be enhanced, to be visible. So this required us to do a lot. I'll just quickly show you some snapshots through which through which I'll try to convey the details. So for example, I had to disintegrate a video frame into its many components. So in this picture, I had to identify the instructor outtake, the instructor out of the image. I have to identify the different parts, the background, and this is a high resolution screencast, high resolution snapshot of the presentation, which is not a video of the presentation, but a screen share kind of a thing. So how do we combine these different individual elements together so that we can blend them together and give a coherent view that looks very real-like? So that's where we went into these algorithms, where we had to change this high resolution screencast to fit in this frame, fit in this portion of the frame, and put the different frames again together to get a blended view. To do this, we used something called computer vision markers, something called ARCO markers. So this was again the computer vision part of it. So we have to figure out how one image would fit into the other image. So these markers lend themselves, so we can easily apply algorithms if we have an image with this marker to identify where each point of this marker is. So we do something like mapping of two images which we want to match. So a point in one of the image, where does it correspond to in another image? If we find that out, we can mathematically model, we can mathematically describe how one image can be changed to match the other image. So that's what we did here. So the screencast was put into this portion of the entire broad frame and everything blended together. So that was a part of computer vision related work which we did here. So this we ended up performing many tests to actually see that this indeed is effective, more effective than traditional, than the other e-learning platforms which we have. So this is one work which we did in this which I did in WNA. I'll briefly mention about what we are currently involved in. So extending on similar lines, now we are working on augmented reality. So this field is not new to us. So we have seen many games and many other apps where we view our natural surroundings through a camera. And instead of just viewing what is there, we see a virtual object overlaid somewhere in the real scene. So that basically is augmented reality. So what we are currently doing is applying this technology on heritage sites. So so a sample is, in India we have a lot of heritage sites which are in partially destroyed or dilapidated conditions. So one such sample is this. Like here you can see a third structure had to be here, similar to these two temples here. So our goal here is to, can we apply augmented reality and digitally restore this entire place? So if we can wear a head mounted glass, like you would have seen videos or read about Google Glass, something like that. If we can wear a head mount glass and look at the site, we should not just see these two sites, but the entire site with the third one also reconstructed, so that we can view how this site would have looked in its original form. So there are many technical aspects in doing this. So we have developed a prototype to do that. So one of the technologies involved is photogrammetry, where you create 3D models of an existing object So for that, you have to cover the object in 360 degrees and take snapshots from all directions. Use those images and obtain and generate something called a mesh, like what's shown here. So that gives from the images, you're constructing a 3D model of that object. And then on that, you can render texture, meaning give it colors and the look of how it is. So we did that and we used something like this, a 3D model. So for our prototype, we took a 3D print of this. This is what our tabletop prototype of the site looks like. So now the augmentation of the third temple that should happen here. So that is done through our AR framework, augmented reality framework. So we also made, created this head mount display for viewing this in-house. So we built this out of many components. And when we wear it and run our AR software, so again, you can see it's based on these markers which we saw earlier. So when we do this, we can see the entire picture of the place. So not just this, the third temple, which should have been there, is digitally reconstructed. So this is what we are currently doing. So this has actually many benefits. So not just for the viewer to get an immersive experience of the site, it can also be used to preserve the knowledge. So as a digital repository, you can preserve what was there. And also such a thing can be used as a research or educational tool for architects or scholars to learn. You can interact with such a tool and use it as an educational tool. So that was a gist of what we have been doing here in the area of augmented reality and computer vision. So thank you.